Welcome to this film about how we can use mechanical toys to help the children get a better understanding of biological concepts. For instance, we could use this bird.
The jelly bird?
Yes, exactly.
So what kind of benefits do we have of exploring this automata instead of going out in the nature?
Yeah, I would absolutely recommend going out in the nature and study wildlife in the real habitat. But when working with this, constructing it, I think the children will naturally focus on the different parts. They will focus on the wings, on the beak, on the tail, on the legs, and so on. Mm. And while we are doing that, we can talk about these parts and why they look like they do, why what they are used for, and why a bird is a bird, things like that. Mm. And then we can go out. Now we are going to talk about how we can use these toys to talk about how animals are adapted to the environment they live in.
So this, what would you say this is?
Well, I think maybe many of the children would say that it is a bird, but maybe someone would say it's a fish or something. Okay. Then we could say, well, it got wings.
Oh, so this also could be a bat or an insect then?
Yeah, bats and insects got wings, but I don't think it looks like that. Maybe because it's got a beak, yeah. Birds got a beak, they got feathers. We can't tell from this particular toy, but maybe we could put feathers on if the children thinks that is something that it needed, is needed to make it a bird.
Okay. So playing with this automata, you can actually talk about different kind of birds and yeah.
Yes, and this is quite a general scheme of a bird, but you have made some other birds.
Yeah, made this one because yeah, maybe you can tell me, you can guess what kind of bird you think this is and
yes,
why.
That is simple to me because I think it looks like an eagle. And why is it an eagle?
You tell me.
If you look at the feet, it's got claws, sharp pointy claws to catch a prey. For example, if it's catching a slippery fish in the water, it could dive down, grab it, and be able to hold it. And the beak is very pointy and sharp, so it can use it to tear meat out of a dead rabbit or something like that. So this is a bird of prey. I would maybe call it an eagle.
Yeah. And what about this one? This has a totally a different kind of beak.
Yeah, so...
And wings.
And feet.
And feet.
So it has probably a different lifestyle. The feet are most characteristic, maybe, if we can have a closer look at the feet. They are wide, like the feet of a scuba diver.
So what kind of birds have those feet?
Birds that need to swim.
Like
a duck.
Ah, like Donald Duck?
Exactly, mm. Like Donald Duck. He's got feet like that. And mm. A beak like this.
Yeah.
Some ducks live of plant material. They've got a flat and wide beak, like this one. So I think this is a swimming duck that is feeding on plant. Some ducks eat fish, and they got a beak that is a little bit more similar to the eagle because they are catching prey.
Okay.
So by when we are making this, we know that it's adapted to a lifestyle in the water.
Okay. And this one, this has a totally different kind of beak, and the feet
yeah.
are so much longer, and yeah. Can you tell me about what kind of bird this could be?
It's a bird that lives in shallow water, I think. It walks around in the water on its long legs, so it doesn't have to float necessarily, but it can stand still. And then it uses its long beak to catch prey that are swimming around in the shallow water
okay.
close to it,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
So this is a wading bird. with a different kind of heat, different kind of beat, beak, showing a little bit about the lifestyle of this bird.
So with this jelly bird, you can explore a lot of different birds. But I think the most fantastic with it is just you can use your imagination and create your own kind of birds, and you can go further on and you can create like this one. You have created a human being. Or
yes.
Is it? Why?
Well, has it got wings? No, it's got arms, waving with its arms. So it's not, we can see that it's not a bird because it's, and of course the face is very human. So,
but the principle is the same.
Yes, it's a different way of using the same mechanism.
And that's the beauty with this, that you can just use your imagination and create all kind of species.
Yes,
actually.
And when we have been outdoors looking at, for instance, birds, we can go indoors and make, if we saw a crow, we could try to make that one or something else.
Mm. Yeah.
Now we are going to look further into different adaptations to the lifestyle of some animals. For instance, there is a crocodile lurking in the water, waiting for its prey. What happens?
But it is a crocodile?
Yeah, I think so.
Why? Why do you think so?
Well, it could slightly remind of a snake, but it got a lot of sharp, pointy teeth that I think looks like a crocodile. And the crocodile used these teeth to catch prey.
Mm.
It's got the predator teeth.
Mm.
And we can see by the shape of teeth that what kind of food it eats. I don't know if crocodiles can eat a little bit of plant material, but surely it can't chew them into something very digestible, but maybe some other animals can do that.
This one. So what's?
Oh, I can see what that is.
What's that?
That is animal with tusks and a trunk. It must be an elephant.
What does the elephant eat?
It eats plant material. Yum yum yum.
Okay.
And it may be a little bit difficult to see, but the elephant has got flat teeth that are well suited to crush the plant material, so it's easy to digest it. And by looking at the teeth, we can see on all animals more or less what kind of food they are eating. And we can also see this in other animals like dinosaurs. Some dinosaurs are meat eaters, like this Tyrannosaurus rex. But some dinosaurs lived from plant material, and they got teeth more or less like an elephant has, or a cow or a horse.
And when we're doing this with the children, we do the same as with the jelly bird.
Yeah,
we're exploring. And
talk about the
it.
Teeth. Oh, they're pointy. What do they eat? What is good crocodile food? Where does the crocodile live?
Yeah.
And so on. And then the children can start.
They can maybe use their imagination and create their own crocodiles. And
Yes. Where does this fantasy crocodile live? And what does it like to eat? And so on.
So pink crocodile doesn't exist?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Not until now.
Well.